This tiny teat is going to cover the cell envelope of both gram positive and gram negative bacteria. A cell envelope may include an outer membrane, a cell wall, and a cell membrane. We're going to begin with gram positive bacteria cell envelope. It contains only a cell wall and a cell membrane. If you take a look at the picture, this is our gram positive bacteria. We took a cut of it off, and then we took this and we blew it up into this really nice big picture where we could see everything clearly. This is the cell wall, and this is the cell membrane. So there is no outer membrane in gram-positive bacteria. You'll see that the cell wall made of peptidoglycan is very thick, and then underneath it is the cell membrane. The cell wall contains something called tachoic acids. These are these sort of grayish silver things. Tachoic acids help do a couple things. They can anchor the wall to the underlying cell membrane, so you can see that right here. They play a role in the overall charge of gram-positive bacteria, and they can help in ion permeability through the wall. So we have this big, thick layer of peptidoglycan that we have to get things to pass through if they're coming in or if they're coming out of the cell. Because gram-positive bacteria have a thick peptidoglycan layer, they retain the primary dye in the gram stain crystal violet. For more about the gram stain, please watch my tiny teach on the gram stain. Now let's go on to gram negative bacteria cell envelopes. Gram negative bacteria cell envelopes include an outer membrane, a cell wall, and a cell membrane. So again, here's our gram negative bacterium. We took a piece of it out right here, and then we blew it up so we could really see it. And you'll see there's three layers here in our cell envelope for gram-negative bacteria, not two. We have an outer membrane, we have a cell wall, and we have a cell membrane. The outer membrane in gram-negative bacteria is made of lipopolysaccharide, or LPS. Underneath the outer membrane is a thin layer of peptidoglycan, and then underneath that is the cell membrane. Because of the structure of the cell envelope of gram-negative bacteria decolorize, and they end up the color of the secondary stain and the gram stain. And for more information on that, please listen to my tiny teach about the gram stain.